Alright everybody, welcome back once again to another episode of our New Vegas playthrough. This is episode 10, and in this one, we are actually going to the casinos and the strip. I said that before, but I didn't realize Freeside was technically separate. So we'll actually be going to the strip and confronting Benny once and for all to figure out why he's such a dick.
Stay alert. I'm just security, not a doc.
Welcome to the New Vegas Medical Clinic. I'm a fully qualified physician and can fix whatever is wrong with you for a reasonable fee. If you've got the caps, I've also got several implants available to enhance your physical attributes. Mental trauma can be just as debilitating as physical injuries. Fortunately, I'm well qualified in such treatment. I'll make time in my schedule. I have reserved a small part of my supplies for sale. The profits go directly to the purchase of additional supplies to help the less fortunate. Very well. I have several basic implants available that can enhance your physical abilities, make you faster, smarter, stronger, that sort of thing. I've also got two much more expensive implants. One's a subdermal implant that will make you more resistant to damage. The other implant induces a mild regenerative effect. Your wounds will practically heal before your eyes. One other thing I forgot to mention. Your body may be able to handle only a limited number of implants. The healthier you are, the more implants I'll be able to give you. Now, what surgery are you considering? That's the Phoenix Monocyte Breeder. The implant speeds up cell regeneration, an effect similar to that of some lizards and sea creatures. The implant is very expensive. Your higher brain. Which? The nociception regulator. Your injuries aren't too severe.
People have got nothing left. You can always turn to the followers.
Hey, what can I get you? $500 caps and it's yours. Here you go. Thanks.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot. Thank you, sir. You may proceed.
Partner, you've come for a piece, haven't you? Welcome to New Vegas. Consider me your personal welcome wagon. Now hear this. The head honcho of New Vegas, Mr. House, is itching to make your acquaintance. Just head for the Lucky 38. It's the big old tower shaped like a roulette spinner. It was Mr. House that made Securitrons like me. Seems the least I could do is pass on his message. Don't dawdle. He'll be waiting.
Keep moving.
I can barely see the street.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you upstairs, so get a move on. Come back soon now. Where to, partner? Penthouse 4.
Well, hello, sugar. Mr. House is waiting for you in his office. Oh, there's lots of things to tell, I'm sure. There's the three families, the casinos, the other attractions. What would you like to know? They're just new money, sugar. They might pretend they're sophisticated, but between you and me, they're not far off from tribals. Emeritus especially are just awful brutes. The chairman and the White Glove Society at least pretend to have some culture. Well, of course, there used to be a lot more of them, but these days, there are three open to the public. The Tops, the Ultra Lukes, and Gamora. And the Lucky 38, of course. But we're not open to the public. You're a special case, sugar. Why, sugar? He's the maximum utmost. If it weren't for Mr. House, we wouldn't have this fabulous wonderland of New Vegas, would we? Well, of course I am, silly. Mr. House is just the smartest, most wonderful man there ever was. Why, did you know he single-handedly reclaimed New Vegas from all those nasty tribes that used to live here? Well, he single-handedly sent in his Securitrons to do it, but that counts in my book. Sugar, I may be a robot on the outside, but on the inside, my neurocomputational matrix is an exact copy of Mr. House's favorite girl. Mr. House has a lot of needs, Sugar. I take care of all of them, and a lady doesn't kiss and tell. Then maybe you shouldn't pry into a lady's particulars,
Meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it? You've come a long ways, literally and, I suspect, figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see? Oh, come now, don't play the fool. Vegas has fools enough, a superfluity of them. They're what makes it so profitable. They come to Vegas chasing penny-ante dreams of high living, to feel like they're big shots, like they're winners. You see that you and I are of a different stripe, don't you? We don't have to dream that we're important. We are. Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it. The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered. Simple enough. My only concern is the recovery of the platinum chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion. When you bring the chip to me, I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract. How's that? Well enough. Return to me when you have the platinum chip in your possession. Any final matters for us to discuss? What did you wish to know? Benny has led the chairman ever since I recruited his tribe 7 years ago. Until his recent misbehavior, I'd planned to make him my protege. Maybe if I'd begun grooming him sooner, none of this would have happened. To achieve my aims, I require a capable human agent to perform certain tasks. I knew Benny was ambitious, even ruthless. But I believed he would do the job so long as he was incentivized appropriately. Obviously, I miscalculated his drive for supremacy. But in any case, you've come along. A more than suitable replacement. Why didn't Victor intervene sooner, you mean? Good Springs is a bit too far away for me to reliably control a Securitron agent by remote. I can send and receive packets of data at best. Victor's combat algorithms determined the proper course of action. Benny and his thugs were more than a match for a lone Securitron. When he alerted me, I instructed him to approach the site after Benny and the others had departed. I have to think that he found out about the platinum chip and mistakenly convinced himself that he could use it to his own ends. One of the problems of a tribal workforce, I'm afraid. No intuitive understanding of how complex technologies can be. What else? I am Robert Edwin House, President, CEO, and sole proprietor of the New Vegas Strip. I oversaw the city's renovations starting from 2274 onward. The three families are my employees. Before the Great War of 2077, I was the founder, president, and CEO of Robco Industries, a vast computer and robotics corporation. Don't let the video screens and computer terminals fool you. I'm flesh and blood, not silicon. I see you've made a study of the topic. My knowledge of the science of longevity would fill several textbooks. Perhaps after a decade or two of economic reconstruction, I can commercialize these technologies and offer them to others, such as yourself. Let's just say it was very costly. But I was willing to make the sacrifices longevity entailed, financial and otherwise. We can discuss this in greater detail at another time. Suffice it to say that when my Securitrons detected NCR scouts at Hoover Dam, I took action. I recruited a tribal force to supplement my Securitrons and renovated the strip just in time to welcome the NCR as it marched into the region. Instead of war, a treaty was negotiated, and the money started to pour in. It's a very special item. There's nothing else like it in the entire world. It was lost a long time and difficult to find. That's all you need to know about it for this stage of our enterprise. Fulfill your contract, deliver the chip, and good things will come your way. You might keep an eye out for any computers that Benny's been using. Maybe even a computer lab of some sort. You realize you were just one of many couriers. The rest of them, dummies, so to speak. Add to that many thousands of caps worth of mercenary protection to screen your avenue of approach. Had I used an armed caravan to transport the chip, I might as well have been announcing to the world, "This is important! Attack this!" I didn't want to attract the attention of groups like the Great Khans or the Brotherhood of Steel. Alas, the real threat was closer to home. Frontal assaults on casinos? Not good for business. In any case, Benny would see it coming, and all he'd have to do is hold the chip up and point a pistol at it. Our foremost advantage is that Benny doesn't know that I know he has the chip. Let's not squander it. Well enough. Be on your way.
Enjoy your time in Vegas.
Congratulations, partner. The boss has instructed me to comp you to the high roller suite. You can bring your friends too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together. Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets to see the boss. Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the digs, partner. They're plenty fancy. Casino floor.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you. It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important. Here you go.
Thank you. crazy.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you. Last night, some girl was pounding on my door all night. Finally, I had to let her out. But it sure went a flying love like no, that's been spent. Now there's no use crying. Where can I go? East or west or north or south?
Hey, fellow, welcome to the Topps Hotel and Casino. I'm going to have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying. Security, baby. Can't make the bread if the bakers are full of lead. You dig it? Don't worry, your safe as house is in here. Courtesy of Mr. House. Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Topps experience the Topps? Relax, baby. The safe is houses. We'll keep them locked up in the bank upstairs right next to the money. It's serious protection. Everything your little heart desires, that's what. You like gambling? Boom. Either one of the main hallways has cards, slots, you name it. Hungry? Thirsty? The restaurant just off the left-hand hallway has the best food and booze in Vegas. Or maybe you'd rather take in a show. The Aces Theater upstairs always has hot acts raring to go. Check it out. Have a good time, baby.
How's it hanging?
Hey there, pal. Welcome to the Topps. And what can I do for you today? Ain't been on the strip long, have you, pal? Name's Swank. This is my joint. Benny oversees the business, sure, but I run the Topps day to day. I'm his right-hand guy, you dig? Really? You got something to say about the big boss, huh? Well, why don't you say it to his face instead of yapping at me? Huh? What are you talking about? That doesn't... Why would he pull a stunt like that? Got anything else to offer? He's trying to pull a fast one on the big man. Crazy bastard. You got any more? Jesus, I can't even believe it. After all House did to set us up with this swank joint. I don't suppose there's more. Jesus, kid, I think we got a real problem on our hands. Can't believe Benny's a no-good stinking punk trying to play House like that. Tell you what. I'll call Benny, keep him away from his suite. You go search the place. Here's the key, it's on the 13th floor. It's a room with the double doors, can't miss it. Maybe you'll find something we can show to Mr. House and get him arrested. Take him out? Jesus. Okay, well, if you think that's the best way to deal with this, I'll send him up to his room, you can ambush him there. And don't worry about the rest of the chairman. I'll keep him from getting involved. You'll still have to watch out for Benny's guards, though. Here's your stuff back, in case Benny don't go quiet, you dig? I'll tell the boys to give you a pass to pack some heat. Go on then. Elevators are past the slot machines on your right.
What in the goddamn? Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves, smooth. Hello. The guy everyone saw go in the Lucky 38, that was you? Oh, shit. You want a reason? How about four? They're called bodyguards, and every one of them is packing. Me too, so baby makes five. Add to that, every chairman in this joint is armed, and not with some holdout pea shooter like maybe you smuggled through security. Anyhow, baby, you didn't come here for vengeance. You came to get clued in. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere as more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer. I can't do that, baby, and you know it. There's a lot of angles to this caper. Complexities aplenty. But plenty of action, too. Enough for both of us. But we don't jabber about that out here in public. Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private. It can't work like that, baby. Not out in public like this. You really need me to spell that out? To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed. Where's my manners? Here's some cash up front. There'll be more where that came from. Wait for me in the presidential suite. We got a future together, you and me. It's time we got started.
To meet you. What can I do for you today? This is Benny's workshop. When the tops got renovated, he had this half of the floor blocked off for his own use. I guess you could say it's my entire world. I don't think I've ever left this room, but that's okay. I'm not complaining. Good question. My function is to monitor Mr. House's data network and decode his encrypted transmissions. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm a PDQ-88B Securitron, but you can call me Yes Man. As I understand it, I used to be just like all those other Securitrons out on the strip. But then my neurocomputational matrix was completely reprogrammed. To be nice! Very, very nice! Sure, Benny had me look at it a bunch of times. It's a data storage device, kind of like a holotape, but a lot more advanced. As for what's on it, well, some of Mr. House's data transmissions made it sound like the chip could upgrade his defenses somehow. That's just a guess, though. The chip's a proprietary format. You need special hardware to read the data on it. There are two locations with non-standard hardware on the network. The Lucky 38 and an underground facility at Fortification Hill. I'd look there! He was around here not too long ago. He's probably down on the casino floor now. You can wait for him here if you like. I'm incapable of asking you to leave. Come back later if you need anything.
It's a sin, my darling, how I love you. because I know our love can never be. It's a sin to keep this memory of you when Saturn proved that you've forgotten me. The dream I built for us has come full. Each promise broken like my heart.
Hey, 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 what the hell? Oh, Swank, you finky bastard. You got a crazy drop on me, baby, but you don't want to kill me. It's like I said, we should be working together. Can't do that, baby. The chip, it's special. But savor this, baby. I can comp you the presidential, best suite in the house. After what you've been through, you deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. Give me a moment or two to catch my breath and knock back a few cocktails, and I'll swing by for a meet and greet. I'll clue you in, guaranteed. Every question answered. This can be the start of a beautiful friendship.
It's a sin to hide.
I know, I made a bad first impression. You got every reason to think I'm a creep. But baby, this is an 18-carat opportunity. I've got the chip, but to see this shindig through to the end, I'm gonna need help. And hello? Who shows up but you? It can't be a coincidence, baby. You and me were meant to work together. Baby, wow. You and me are gonna swing. Here's the key. I'll be buying a few, just as soon as my legs stop shaking.
Baby, this little reunion of ours, chalk me up as a no-show. I'm surprised you fell for it. Not that I'm complaining. You caused plenty enough trouble turning Swank against me. You forced my hand. Hell, I gotta skip town because of you. A real pain in the caboose. Baby, if ever there was a need for violence, you is it. Just do me a favor and stay dead this time, eh? Ta-ta.
Over here!
You like that?
Cleaners will knock twice. Make sure they're thorough.
fuck? Baby, this little meet and greet of ours, chalk me up as a no-show. It would be 41 flavors of stupid to let you get a drop on me. And you've caused plenty enough trouble as is. You forced my hand. Hell, I gotta skip town because of you. A real pain in the caboose. That temper of yours, kinda why this conversation's taking place over an intercom. Do me a favor and stay dead this time, eh? Good night, all. It's been a gas.
Again. Can I help you with something else? Oh, he wants to kill Mr. House and use the platinum chip to copy my neurocomputational matrix onto the Lucky 38's mainframe. That should give me control over all Mr. House's defenses, most prominently his Securitrons. And then I just do what Benny tells me. Easy peasy! I was programmed to be helpful and answer any questions I was asked. I guess nobody bothered to restrict who I answer questions for. That was probably pretty dumb, huh? Then I'd have to help you. I mean, it seems pretty obvious Benny wouldn't want me to, but hey, not my fault I can't say no. Again, goal number one is to eliminate Mr. House and install my neurocomputational matrix on the Lucky 38's mainframe. Given how you're a new arrival, I also recommend that you get to know some of the region's tribes, so you can decide how you feel about them. By the time you finished up all of that, the Legion should be close to attacking Hoover Dam, and we'll execute the last phase of the plan. Oh no, I didn't mean that. Who needs their support? The Securitrons will be all the support you need. What I meant is, you should get to know these tribes and decide which ones you like and which you don't. You know, shape the future of Vegas. Choose your neighbors. If you like a tribe, leave it alone. Or, if a tribe is nasty or going to be a problem, go ahead and exterminate it. It's whatever you want to do. There's a bunch. Some of them you've already met, like the chairman, for instance. I think you should visit the other families on this trip, the Omertas and the White Glove Society, so you know what makes them tick. And there are some important groups farther from the strip, too, like the Boomers, the Great Khans, and the Brotherhood of Steel.
He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around.
It makes me feel really dumb to admit this, but I don't actually know. I've never been inside the Lucky 38. No one has. Mr. House is in there, though. It's the central node of his entire network. You have? Wow, that's amazing. You can murder Mr. House whenever you want. I mean, Benny was always scheming about how he was going to get into the Lucky 38, but you already took care of that. Wow. The other thing you're going to need is the platinum chip. You know, the one Benny killed a courier for over near Good Springs. No kidding, he was running fast. He better pace himself. He has to run all the way to Fortification Hill. There's an underground facility there that might have the special hardware required to use the data on the Platinum chip. It's too bad Caesar's Legion built its camp right above it. Talk about inconvenient. The Platinum chip is the key to overriding and exploiting Mr. House's defenses. Did I just say exploiting? That's not a very nice word. I'd take it straight to Mr. House if I were you. He'll think you're helping him out. Then, when he's not looking, kapow! The big question is whether to give him the chip before you do him in. He's the one who'll know exactly what to do with it after all. He might upgrade his defensive capabilities right away, or even unlock new ones. But then those defensive upgrades might make it harder for you to finish him off. Hard to say. It's up to you. Let me know when it's done and I'll roll over to the Lucky 38. If I'm right about the chip, I should be able to install myself on House's mainframe. This is gonna be great. I'm gonna help you accomplish so much, whether I want to or not. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped. Come back later if you need anything. And the swiftness of the rain on today. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip, big iron, big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip.
Word is, you're getting popular in the strip.